And welcome back to game number two of day number two for the I-90 Invitational Tournament. Back-to-back games for the CTW Crystal Title Waves. They'll be playing against Homer Heat. And Homer Heat played last night against the Huntley Red Raiders. Fell 8-0, but they'll get a second chance in looking for their first win of the tournament. We welcome you here in Elgin, Illinois. Beautiful day outside, and we welcome you inside the broadcast booth. I'm Nick Martinez alongside Justin Brzezinski. Justin joining me for a couple games, maybe, or this game.
Yeah, we'll see.
Yeah, see how it goes. CTW will be the away team. They'll lead us off for game number two of day two here in Judson University, home of the Golden Eagles since 1963. Top of the first, and we'll have our leadoff hitters for CTW. CTW just lost to Huntley 7-3. It was a close battle, and it was back and forth the entire way. CC Grigas will pitch for Homer Heat. That one cracked deep over to second, and that'll be an easy first out for Homer Heat. We'll get the first out against CTW. Leadoff hitter for Charlotte Fink. Pitcher Addie Osborne up to bat for CTW. Osborne had a good day pitching in the last game. Look to continue it here with some good at-bats in the first trip for CTW. That one cracked high over to the second baseman. That'll be second out for CTW. Good play from Homer Heat early on in this game to get quit two outs. Next hitter up for CTW. That'll be Bacon. Juliana Bacon. Going to be an architect when she gets older. Foul ball deep into the cage there. That'll be strike one. 1-1 count, two outs for CTW. Scoreless so far in the top of the first. Bacon deep to center. That'll get down for a base hit. Good start so far for Bacon. That's a good way to start for CTW. You know, get a base hit early on in the game, sets the tone. Next hitter up for CTW, Juliana Tito. A couple base hits in the last game against the Red Raiders. Pitch again, that one struck high over in the right. That'll be a foul ball. Bacon will head back to first. And the reset here for Tito. CC Grigas, another pitch. Safe at first, the try, not in time. Good effort though from Homer Heat. And the throw over to Young at first base. And that'll be a base on balls. Two runners out there now at first and second for Homer Heat. Make that Bacon and Tito, the two runners. For Ferrante high over in the right field, and the catch will be made for out number three. Scoreless inning so far in this game. CTW had a couple base hits, but no runs on the board early on in this game. CTW will take the infield and the outfield for the first time in this second game. Their back-to-back game here today. And it looks like, let's see what pitcher we'll get. We saw Ferrante early on in the last game. And it looks like she'll lead off here for CTW. Mia Fiquette will stay in the catcher's position as we'll get our leadoff hitters for Homer Heat in the top of the order set to bat for the first time in this game. The Heat don't allow any runs in the top of the first, and it's got to feel good going into the bottom of the first. No runs in top of the order. Get some runs on the board, get an early lead. Sam Mahoney to lead us off for Homer Heat. First batter up against Ferrante and the CTW squad. First pitch in this game hits our umpire, takes it like a champ. Little break in play. Umpire will clean home plate. And Sam will get another chance in the batter's box against Ferrante. Scoreless so far in this game, 0-1 counts. And Homer Heat looking to strike first early in this game. Another pitch underway, that one high, and that'll be the first ball for Ferrante. Another pitch, high foul ball. That'll go over the net. And that'll be strike two. 1-2 count for the leadoff hitter, Sam Mahoney, and the Homer Heat. Another high foul ball, that time not getting over the net. Ferrante, some good pitching early on. Sam battling so far in the batter's box. 1-2 count, she'll step up once again. The Rapunzel fan at bat. That'll be high for ball two. Even count for Mahoney. Bottom of the first, no run scored yet. That one cracked over into center field, and that'll get down for a base hit. Homer Heat get the first runner out there on base, and a good start for the Heat as they look to strike first with no outs and Sam over at first. Pitch underway, and that'll be an automatic walk. Juliana Gray will get over to first and make that two runners out there on base for the Heat. What a way to start early on in this game. Bunt try there. That'll be a fair ball. Throw over to first will be in time for the first out of this inning. Runners into scoring position at second and third. Coley Sievers now up to bat for Homer Heat. Verante the pitch. That one deep into left. That'll be a foul ball for Gray. Verante will reset at the pitcher's mound. Two runners out there at second and third for the Heat, looking to get on the board first. Only one gone, and a swing and a miss. A strong pitch there from Verante. And Sievers faces an 0-2 count. One gone in the bottom of the first. Trying to load the bases up for the Heat. Foul tip there, way to stay in it. Stay in the batter's box. Heat set up once again. Tidal waves. Swing and a miss. That'll be strike three for Verante. Tidal waves getting it done for the second out. Verante's done a great job the entire tournament with runners in scoring position, not allowing a ton of runs to be scored when runners are at second and third. Verante will set up once again. That one struck hard over to first base, and that'll end the inning for the Homer Heat. Great play from both teams, and through the first inning, it is still scoreless. Homer Heat and the Tidal Waves back and forth. Some good pitching and some good at-bats for both teams.
And this timeout is sponsored by Daryl Burns Photography for portraits, family photos, and graduation photos, sports team photos, and more. Contact Daryl Barnes Photography at darylbarnes.com.
Grigas set to pitch for her second straight inning. Young over at first, made a good play in the top of the first, and now we've reached the top of the second, still scoreless. It only takes one hit for a team to take the momentum early on in these types of games. Great camera work from our Beacon Academy crew. Thank you to all the students helping put these streams together. Also, of course, thank you to all the parents and volunteers that make this such a great an event every year, the I-90 tournament here at Judson University. CTW up to bat once again in the top of the second. Grigas to pitch once again for Homer Heat. Abby Lawson, the batter, leadoff batter for CTW. A good eye there. Takes ball one. Back-to-back balls for Lawson. Two-oh counts. The pitch high there. Make it three. And a chance to get on base for CTW. The pitch. That'll be ball four. And base on balls for Lawson. Good play there for CTW. That one struck right over to the shortstop, and the play will be made for the first out in this game. Kendall, number two, now up to bat for CTW. One runner out at first. One gone in the top of the second. The throw to first is not in time. Another pitch for the Heat. That one right over to third base. That'll get down for a base hit. Back-to-back hits there for CTW and make it two runners over at first and second. Still only one out in this game in the top of the second. CTW looking to strike first and to get some runs on the board. That pitch high and runners will advance to second and third. In scoring position goes the Tidal Waves. And a big play could be brewing. The 1-1 pitch will make it ball two. Still only one out, two runners out there for CTW. Good eye there, and that'll be ball three. 3-1 count, potential to load the bases. Good pitch there from Grigas. That'll get strike two to make it a full count. Both teams battling it out. As we mentioned, only one out. Still plenty to work with for CTW. That pitch high, and the bases now are loaded for the Tidal Waves.
Our next batter is Riley Martin. She wants to be a vet, and she's older.
Martin takes ball one there. Looking to get on the scoreboard is CTW. Both teams scoreless through one inning. That one struck deep into center field. Two will look to score here for CTW. Right through the hands of the catcher for Homer Heat and make it two runs now scored for Crystal Tidal Waves. A strong infield double for Martin. And that'll make the scoring started for CTW. High pitch there, watching first. Another pitch here. That'll be wide for ball two. Runners at second and third. CTW in control with only one out. That one struck hard over to the shortstop and the play will be made. And no out will be made as no force out was established and no bag was tagged. So that'll make it runners at first and third for CTW and make it another run to score. And that'll be three runs now for the Tidal Waves as the try to second will be in time. 0-1 count, runners at second and third. 3-0 game, that one struck hard. That'll get down into left field. CTW will add another run on the board and another base hit to get runners at first and second. Martin will come in to score, and this is the inning for the Tidal Waves. High pitch there. Runners will stay.
Up to bat now is Juliana Bacon. She's planning to be an architect when she's older.
Pitch wide there. And Bacon, one of the good hitters on this CTW team, got on base early on in the first. And now two runners out on first and second. CTW, another crack at it here. And that'll be strike one. Good pitching we're seeing from Grigas. 1-1 count, one gone in the top of the second. That'll be ball two there. Make it ball three, 3-1 count. Chance to load the bases once again for CTW with still only one out gone. Foul tip there, make it a full count now for Bacon. Three, two, Homer Heat looking for the second out in this second inning. Grigas, the pitch will be high for ball four. And load the bases once again for CTW as Tito will head into the batter's box once again in this game with Verante on deck for CTW. This could be a really big play for CTW. Already have the lead, and now with three runners out there on base and only one out, this could be huge for their team.
Yeah. With Juliana Tito is now up to bat. If she gets a good solid hit, we could get some more points on the board.
Another pitch that time will be a little high in the zone. Make it ball one. 1-0 count. Only one gone in the second. Got to be careful. Three runners out there. 2-0 counts. Grigas the pitch. That'll be strike one. 2-1 counts. Tito, good eye there. As that'll be low for ball three. One more ball, and that'll add another run on the board. CTW already has four in this game. Tito to set up again. Full count. One gone. Big pitch here for Homer Heat. That'll be wide, and that'll be another automatic run. Make it 5-0 for CTW, scoring in this inning five of their runs. And Verante will be up to bat for CTW. Homer Heat down by five runs. Swing and a miss there. A good strong pitch from Grigas. Verante having some trouble getting contact, but still a lot to work with. Bases loaded, one out. Verante back-to-back strikes. Grigas got her swinging once again. The 0-2 pitch. That'll be a ball one. Five runs scored in the top of the second for CTW. Can they add any more? We shall see, as that'll be high in the zone for ball two, making an even count for Verante. A Another pitch, that one high. And make it a full count. Verante working the count to perfection. Make it 3-2 with one gone. Grigas, big pitch here. That'll be wide for ball four. Make it 6 runs now scored in the top of the second for CTW. 6-run lead and Homer Heat has fell into a bit of a hole here against this tidal wave team. And it looks like we will have a pitching change for Homer Heat. New pitcher up at the mound. Leah, number 29, coming into the game, taking the pitcher's mound, and she'll face Abby Lawson, one of the great hitters on this CTW team. Homer Heat down by 6 runs. Bases loaded still. With still only one out, it's been the same story so far in the top of the second. Lawson, good eye there. That'll be strike one, a good pitch from Grigas. That one low, gotta be careful of base runners here. Leah, the pitch there, make it strike two. 1-2 count. Leah Burnt, the pitch once again. That'll be a foul ball. Still only one gone. Lawson trying to send some more runs in. Another pitch for Burns. That'll be fouled back once again. Top of the second, 6 runs scored for CTW early on in this game. Another pitch, Lawson will foul that for the third time in a row. Still a 1-2 count. Leah the pitch, got her swinging, and Lawson will get retired from Leah Burns coming into the game and already getting her first strikeout of the tournament. That one cracked over into right field, and the catch will be made for out number two. Make that out three. As Burns will retire the side for CTW, and Homer Heat in a little bit of a hole here after that second inning from CTW. Let's see if they can respond and try to cut into the lead of CTW. CTW is in a similar position as the Homer Heat, as they were down by 6 runs but cut in half. We've seen a lot of comebacks so far in this tournament.
Yeah, I agree with you there.
Ferrante set to pitch once again in the bottom of the second. That'll be foul ball number one. 6-0 is your score. CTW on top. After a scoreless first inning, the tidal waves jumped out to a 6-run top of the second. Shows bunts, and that'll be a foul ball there for Homer Heat. Maddie Barber, leadoff hitter for Homer Heat. Ferrante set to pitch once again. That one high in the zone, make it ball one. The 1-1 pitch. Got her swinging there. And the play will be made over to first for out number one in the bottom of the second. Heads up play there from Charlotte Fink, the catcher for CTW. Ferrante, another pitch. And that'll be strike one. CC Grigas, the pitcher for Homer Heat, facing off against Ferrante. And that'll be an automatic walk right there. Young now up to bat for Homer Heat. The first baseman now getting a chance inside the batter's box with one gone. That one high foul ball will head over into the bleachers. We're seeing a lot of bleacher foul balls so far in this game.
Yeah, it's a good thing they're not all sitting back there. It looks like there's some more people now, but earlier one smacked right in the middle.
Yeah, you got to be careful. You got to have your mitt ready to catch it.
Oh, yeah.
Young a swing, and that'll be strike two. High ball there, and runner will head to second. Young. Grigas at second, Young to bat. 1-2 count, Grigas the pitch. That one high, foul ball there. One, two count, one gone. Ferrante has been the pitcher the entire day so far. Not allowing any runs to be scored for Homer Heat. Ferrante, wild pitch there. They'll waver to third. And Grigas now in deep scoring position over at third base. Homer Heat looking to respond after that CTW blast in the top of the second. Another pitch there. That'll be ball number three. Make it a full count now for Young. Potential to put two runners over on base. One gone. Ferrante will set. The 3-2 pitch will foul back into the cage once again for Young. Same situation, full count, one gone. Ferrante, the pitch to Young. Cracked over to the shortstop. The play will be made in time. Make it safe. Bobble on the catch, and that'll be a base hit. And another run scored for Homer Heat, making their first of the game. And with that run, that's Homer Heat's first run of the tournament. Great way to start and great way to respond. That fouled in the right field.
Looks like we have Hannah Farley up to bat for the Homer Heat.
First time we're seeing Farley here today. That'll be ball one. Make it a 1-1 count. One gone and one runner currently out there for Homer Heat. Make it Young over at first. As the Heat still down by 5 runs and a good pitch there from Verante. Make it a 1-2. Verante will set once again. High foul ball for Farley. One, two count, one gone. Homer Heat looking to get some more runs on the board and cut into the lead of CTW. Even 2-2 count. Runner at first. Can Farley send Young to second, maybe even third? Swing and a miss, and Verante's got her for the out. Out number two of the inning. Good pitching there from Verante. Verante, another pitch to Ballantyne. And that'll be strike one. Got her swinging. Brim Ballantyne pitched last night against the Huntley Red Raiders. As that'll be strike two. 0-2 count. Trying to retire this side is Verante. One runner out there over at first. Two outs, 0-2 count. Big pitch for the tidal waves. Got her swing in, and that'll be strike three. Only one run allowed in the bottom of the second. The first run scored for Homer Heat, but Verante's great pitching continues through two innings.
This is sponsored by Custom Heating and Cooling for all of your heating or cooling needs. Count on Custom Heating and Cooling of Chicagoland, featuring sales, installation, and 24-hour emergency service. Find them online at customheating.com. Go to...
Now, Justin, you're one of our leaders here at the Beacon Academy, putting all these streams together. It's just such a fun event to come to every year, especially with all these teams, all the parents, the energy. It's just a great event every year.
Yeah, I've been here the past 4 years, and you know it's fun to watch and you know put together. It's great.
Yeah, I think this is my third year doing it, but it's just a great job from our Beacon Academy crew. As we have CTW up once again to bat in the top of the third. They still have a 5-run lead in this one. That one hard and struck over to first. That'll be a foul ball. Catch almost made from Sam Mahoney over at first. Good contact early for CTW. As Kendall will face the 0-2 pitch from Burns. That one a little low right there. One, two pitch. That one fouled back into the cage. I mean, we were talking how fun this event is every year for us, but it's also great exposure for these players, you know, getting the tournament style games, getting that kind of feel for this high level of competition, especially since in the future a bunch of these girls, as we're seeing, are going to high schools and are going to look to play softball in high school. It's just good for them to get some practice in, especially in the summer too.
Yeah, for sure, for sure. These games will be up there on YouTube for a while, yeah.
Yeah, and for family and stuff, you know, not everyone can make these games in these tournaments, and it's just good to have that outlet to watch games and to watch these players. That'll be strike one on the first pitch for Burns, Leah Burns, for Homer Heats. Came in the last inning replacing Grigas. And that'll be high in the zone for ball one. Make it a 1-1 count with one gone in the top of the third. That one a little low there for ball number two. Make it a 2-1 count. Swing and a miss there. A good pitch from Burns. Evens the count there.
And at bat here is Frankie Pazon. She's number 28. She got a jacket on, though, so we can't see her number.
That'll be fouled back there. Frankie, one of the good hitters on this CTW team. A lot of the star players in these tournaments are part of teams that are so deep at each position. That's what's given them the lead so far in this game, is a lot of base hitters and runners out there.
Yeah, some pretty solid hits I've seen throughout the day today.
That'll be a foul tip there. Keep it at a 2-2 count. One gone in the top of the third. Make that a 3-2 count, full count. For CTW. Looking for out number two. And they'll get it. Strikeout for the Homer Heat. Great pitching we're seeing from Leah Burnt.
Up to bat now, Riley Martin.
Martin strikes that over to first. And that'll be an easy out for Homer Heat. That'll be three quick outs to end the top of the third. Make it 6-1 still through three and a half innings. Five-run lead still for CTW. CTW, what a way to respond after losing a close battle between one of the tournament's best teams, the Huntley Red Raiders. 7-3 was the final score in our previous game. And now CTW holds on to a lead of their own. Great pitching the entire day from Mia Verante. Made that Skyly Verante, number 17. As well as Addie Osborne in the last game. A lot of deep pitchers on this CTW team. Denton will lead it off for Homer Heat to start the bottom of the third. Heat scored their first run of the tournament and their last trip at bat. And Denton will set up in the batter's box and will face Verante once again. 0-1 count. Another pitch that time, a little inside the zone. That'll make it a 1-1 count. Ah. second pitch is a strike. Two strikes now, 1-2 count for the leadoff hitter of Homer Heats. High hit ball there for Denton. That'll get down and foul. Keeps it at 1-2. Denton sets up against Barante, this time into left field, and the catch will be made for the first out of this one. Frankie getting the play over in left field. And Barante will retire her first hitter in the bottom of the third. That one high in the zone there. That'll be ball one. Sam loads up in the batter's box once again. Right over to Verante. Some miscommunication, and that'll be safe at first for Sam. Verante, little confusion there with the second baseman. And that'll be an easy base hit for Homer Heat. First runner out on base in the bottom of the third.
The Gray up to bat now. She wants to be a photographer when she gets older. Should invite her to the Beacon Academy.
Yeah, yeah. Get some camera crew additions. Trying for second. And she'll be safe. Great play there for Sam. And she'll wait in scoring position. That one high, foul over the net once again for Gray. Runner at second, one out in the bottom of the third. Homer Heat still down by 5 runs. Looking to cut into the lead even more. They scored their first run in this game, their last trip here in the second. That'll be low, and runners will head to third and safe. Sam Mahoney will wait at third. Potential to score the second run of the day. One out, 1-1 count. High foul ball there. Once again, make it a 1-2 count. Gray will set up in the batter's box once again. Runner at third. Foul tip there for Gray. Mahoney at third, Lawson watching her carefully for CTW. High foul ball once again, keeps it at a 1-2 count, one gone. And this 5-run deficit for Homer Heat. Bottom of the third, Verante. Another pitch that time, little low. That'll even the count at 2-2. That'll be ball three. Make it now a full count. Gray has worked it to perfection. Once in a 1-2 hole, now makes it 3-2. Big pitch for both teams. Marante looking for the second out here. And that one's high over to first, and the catch will be made for CTW. Runners will stay over at third. Good pitching there from Verante, and that'll make it out two. And another quick out for Homer Heat.
Number 29, Leah Burdett. Butchered the name. She must be a doctor when she gets older.
Leah the pitcher will face Verante, and that'll be a foul ball over the net once again. Two outs, two gone. Runner over at third for Homer Heat. That'll be ball one for Verante against Leah. Leah trying to send Sam over to tag for another run. Still down by five runs are the Homer Heat. That'll be strike two. One strike away from ending the third inning. Verante sets for the 1-2 pitch. That one over to first. And CTW will make the play for the third out. And that'll end the third inning with the score 6-1 after three. Still CTW holding on to the 5-run lead. And CTW will get their fourth chance up to bat. Charlotte Fink will lead us off here for the Crystal Tidal Waves. The catcher trying to make something happen here for CTW. Still hold on to a 5-run lead, but doesn't hurt to add some extra insurance runs. As that was a ball one. Good eye there from Charlotte. Leah Burns, still the pitcher for Homer Heat. Back-to-back balls there. They get a 2-0 count. That one foul ball over to third. And Fink will head back to home plate, facing the 2-1 count. The pitch there high, and a good eye there from Fink. 3-1. Looking to get on base for the first time in this fourth inning. That one high and left. That'll be a foul ball. Make it a full count now for Fink. Good contact we're seeing from Fink. Trying to lead off in a big way as she faces the 3-2 count. Up by five. Swing and a miss, and a good pitch there for Homer Heat. Leah gets the first strikeout in this fourth inning. Great way to respond after the last couple of innings.
We're back up to the top of the batting. We have Addie Osborne. She wants to be a baker.
Saw some good pitching from Osborne in the last game as well. Osborne faces the second pitch. And that'll be the first strike. Make it 1-1 counts for Osborne. Burns another pitch. That one cracked over to second, and the play will be made in time for out number two.
That out made by number eight, Sam. Great timing and great catch.
Yeah, the communication, kind of like we saw the miscommunications for CTW, but Homer Heat's been in sync basically the entire day so far.
Yeah, that's pretty important when you're in that team dynamic.
That one will get down for a base hit for Bacon. And the first pitch ends up in a single for Bacon. Juliana Bacon, number five, will get on to first, and we'll wait and see if Juliana Tito can send her further. That one cracked high over towards first. That'll be a foul ball. CTW up to bat again. 0-1 hole with two gone in the top of the fourth. One runner currently over at first. The pitch that time low, and runner will stay. Sam taking her time over for the Crystal Tidal Waves. That one's strong into left field, making two base runners there for CTW. Bacon and Tito at first and second. Big swing here for CTW, trying to hold on to the lead as Berante will step up into the batter's box. That one over to the shortstop, play made in time for the third out. What a way to respond for the Homer Heat, as a little bit of trouble getting some base runners on, but not allowing any runs to be scored. Great job from Homer Heat. And they'll head to the bottom of the fourth, still down five runs.
Staying up to date with training on the latest technology with five-star reviews on Google, Yelp, and Facebook. A business of Elgin, from Elgin, and for Elgin. Custom heating and cooling, trained, reliable, trustworthy.
We're back here in the bottom of the fourth. 6-1 is still the score. Homer Heat haven't managed to come back in this one against the Tidal Waves, after CTW jumped out to a hot start in the top of the second, scoring six runs. Homer Heat responded with their first run of the tournament, but still find themselves down by five. Coley, number 11, will lead us off here in the bottom of the fourth for Homer Heat. Back-to-back scoreless innings for CTW. Let's see if Homer Heat can respond. That'll be high for ball one. Verante making her fourth straight inning pitching for CTW. She'll set up once again. That'll be strike one. Good pitching we're seeing from Verante. Coley in a 1-1 hole. And that'll be back-to-back strikes for Verante. One, two count. That one will get down. And runner will safe at first. Good play there for Homer Heat to get a runner out there on base. Runner out there for Homer Heat over at first. Gonna try for second. And that'll be an out over on second base. Heads up play there from Lawson. And a great play made there from CTW to get the first out in the bottom of the fourth. Strong strike there, and what a catch made. That'll be out number two. Back-to-back impressive outs from CTW. Matty Barber now up to bat for Homer Heat. Heat got an early runner on base, but back-to-back outs from CTW. The bunt try, and that'll be out number three. Heads up play from Verante, and the pitcher makes the play to keep it a 6-1 game through four innings of play. Great pitching from Verante, and great infield defense from this CTW team as Homer Heat still only one run on the board, and they'll have to face the heat of the lineup for CTU coming up in the top of the fifth. Leah Burns will stay on the pitcher's mound for Homer Heat. Five straight innings on the mound. And the Heat will look for to give their third straight scoreless inning for CTW. This game brought to you by our season sponsor, the Bear Family McDonald's. Proud supporters of our community since 1967. Stop by one of their 35 area locations today. Thank you to the Bear family. Thank you to all of our sponsors here at the I-90 Invitational Tournament here at Judson University in Elgin, Illinois, as we're here in day two of this tournament. One more day to go to decide who will take first place. Could it be one of these two teams? Both these teams 0-1 in the tournament. Both teams losing to Huntley. As Lawson will lead us off for CTW. Number 54 faces a 1-1 pitch. Swing and a miss there. A good strong pitch from Burnt. No runs scored for either team in the last two innings. Got her for strike three, and Burnt retires the leadoff hitter for CTW. That'll be a foul ball over towards third base, and that'll fall into left field. Make that strike one. 1 gone in the top of the fifth. High pitch there and a good eye from Fecht. Mia will face the pitch that time a little low. 2-1 count. That pitch high and make it 3-1 now. Looking to get on base for the first time in the top of the fifth. CTW still up by 5 runs. Looking to try to grow the lead, and they'll get a runner out on first base on balls there for Mia. Kendall number two will head up into the batter's box. That one high. And runner safe at first. Good try from the catcher for Homer Heat.
Yeah, quick thinking by Coley Sivers.
Yeah, you got to stay on your feet. Always got to be aware. We've seen a ton of stolen bases in this tournament. A lot of teams have learned over the last couple of days to try to stop the advance of runners. One count, runner at first, fouled back into the cage. That'll make it 1-2. Burnt looking for her second out in this fifth. Another Heat pitch, got her. The try to second will be not in time. Good play there for Mia. And number 12 will wait on second base. And that'll be the second out for CTW. Good play from Homer Heat to get the strike. Still have a runner out there for CTW, a chance to grow the lead. That'll fall over to the shortstop. Play made in time for out number three. Heads up play there from Homer Heat. And that'll be out three. Great job from the Heat. That'll make it three straight scoreless innings for CTW. Great job from the infield play and great awareness from the Heat so far in this game. Still only one run scored for the Heat. This will be one of the last chances for Homer Heat to put some runs on the board and try to come back in this one. But great effort from CTW. This has kind of been the theme for the tournament. Like, the one team will get out to an early lead and then we'll keep it through the entire game.
Yeah. I think this sponsored by Tom the Plumber. Tom the Plumber, Inc. is a family-owned and operated company committed to providing plumbing service and installations of the highest quality and craftsmanship. Tom the Plumber, honest and affordable. Visit Tom online at tomtheplumberinc.com.
Second game here today for the 90 tournament. We're reaching the end of the battle between the CTW Crystal Tidal Waves and Homer Heat. Fast pitch here at Judson University. Verante has had a great day of pitching. Has pitched the entire game so far and starts with an 0-2 count. Bottom of the fifth. Last chance for Homer Heat. Foul ball, we'll keep it at 0-2. Heat down by 5 runs. The pitch from Verante. Roll that a foul ball. Only scoring for both teams came in the second inning. Neither team has been able to score and the other four. CTW, a great response after losing to the Huntley Red Raiders 7-3 in our previous game. It's hard for a team to play a back-to-back in these conditions, back-to-back playing one of the best teams in the tournament, and then being able to switch it around like this, that's very impressive for a team.
Yes, for sure, for sure.
That one high, and the catch will be made for CTW. Two more outs to go for the Tidal Waves.
Yeah, another great hit, but another great catch.
They've lived off those infield catches so far in this game. And they've also lived off Ferrante's pitching, as that'll be a little high for ball one.
Up to bat here, Liana Young.
Ferrante, another pitch that time, low as well. 2-0 counts for Young. One gone, no runners currently out there on base. That'll be a fair ball. Ferrante makes the play over to first, and that'll be out number two. Another heads-up play for Ferrante, and another heads-up play for the CTW team.
Up to bat now, Hannah Farley. Favorite movie's Home Alone. That's a good movie, isn't it?
Yeah, great movie. Ferrante, another pitch. That'll be low there for ball one. Farley will set up once again. Two gone in the bottom of the fifth. Back-to-back balls for Young. 2-0 count. Another pitch, that one strike right up center field, and that'll be a base hit for Homer Heat. Young will get to first, and she'll wait as Ballatine will set up as another batter for Homer Heat. Two gone, fresh count. That one high, and that'll be ball one. Homer Heat still down by five runs. One runner out there. That one struck. That'll get down and deep into left field. Back-to-back base hits now for Homer Heat, and a little something brewing for this Heat team. One runner in scoring position. One runner at first, and Homer Heat could make a last-minute comeback in this one. High ball over to left, and the catch will be made for out number three. And that'll be the game. What a game we saw from the Crystal Tidal Waves. What a way to respond after losing to Huntley. And now they advance to 1-1 in this tournament. Heat still remain winless in this one. Back and forth, but it ultimately came down to that second inning where the Tidal Waves scored 6 runs. And that was where they scored all of their runs in this game. Give credit to the Heat, scored their first run of the tournament, but not enough to beat the Crystal Tidal Waves in this one. Second game of day two here in the I-90 Invitational Tournament. Nick Martinez alongside Justin Brzezinski in the booth. It was great calling a game with you, my man. It was super fun.
It was exciting. It was fun. Learning experience for me.
Yeah. Great job from our Beacon Academy crew. Thank you to all of our sponsors. We'll be back in a quick moment for another game here at Judson University.